and good morning, all the judges and all the audience. My name is Kin Hin Man Woo. I'm from Myanmar Islamic University, Malaysia. I'm doing Master in Computer Science. This is my research work. My topic is approach to detect data ambiguity using libraries that specify algorithm for the software requirements. These are the contents. Okay, for the introduction, for the requirement engineering is a process for producing software requirement specification as well as solving the errors of SRS. Software requirement specification is basically the planning before you develop the website. Let's say you have an LI system, you want to be an LI system, and you ask the software developer to do plan before you. So this SRS is basically the planning. You written it by using natural language, English natural language. Okay, the job of requirement engineer are not only for constructing SRS, but also the solving errors such as ambiguity, inconsistency, and incomplete. So SRS is basically very important because of the constructing statement are producing for design, coding, and testing for software development. So the successful output project is depending on quality of SRS. If there is error in SRS, it could be a problem in your website. So the SRS is the main and the basis for your, before you're developing your software. So in order to construct the software or SRS, we need to write using natural language. Most of the SRS are written in English natural language, and natural language are generally ambiguous. There are four most important types of ambiguity in SRSR: lexical, synthetic, semantic, and pragmatic. Lexical means one word has more than one meaning. Synthetic ambiguity occurs sentence structure is in written more than one way because of ambiguous sentence structure. Semantic and pragmatic are based depend on the meaning of the sentence. Okay, we only focusing on synthetic ambiguity because we want to focus only on sentence structure and grammar ambiguity. Other time we going to focus on meaning, and some other researchers stated that most of the ambiguity found in requirement document are synthetic because of ambiguous word in requirement document. Okay, these research were benefit to requirement engineer, practitioner, and researcher to reduce ambiguity SRS and to be integrated with other requirement tool to be validated using SRS. Our proposed method is using machine learning algorithm, naive data specification based on ML model. Okay, we also identify some ambiguity rule from the handbook, which they have stated. We select some rule from synthetic ambiguity of handbook, and we also select some rule from ambiguity rule from the National Language Software Requirement Specification book. Okay, we select total 5 rules from the ambiguity handbook and National Language Software Requirement Specification are: first one is coordinating congestion ambiguity, which occur when an or a user is sender. For example, user share the email register. So when the user see email or password, so N and O is together, it may confuse the user. Same goes to multiple sentence. If user has to, store manager has to select and change, they have to do either both change and select, or they have to do either one. So it confusing sentence. So same goes to differential ambiguity is pronoun. Like for example, it, they, itself, themselves, like personal pronoun, sometimes. So they, according to one of the requirement statement, the user may access the system whenever they desire. They is represent either user or either the system. So it's confusing. Same goes to quantification, is scope ambiguity which occur to quantify express in the same in various way. The example of quantification are each, every, and all. And for example, according to all data in sentence database, in according to this statement, all can replace with each and every, so it looks ambiguous. And rule five is subjective sentence ambiguity, which has adjective, adverb, and as adjective as, which lead to ambiguity. Okay, from rule one and rule three, rule four, we selected from handbook. From the natural language software requirement, we selected two rules, multiple rule two and rule five. These rules are selected because these are very fundamental in English language grammar and recommend by domain expert, my supervisor, and the which is important for requirement engineer to correctly construct requirement statement using the accurate synthetic structure to avoid ambiguity. So the method we propose is we have naive-based specification algorithm and manually, like human, identify the ambiguity. So there are two methods. In order to select the naive-based dust classification, we select this one because it achieves high accuracy and perform better in other natural language processing and machine learning algorithm in detecting ambiguity in SRS. So the process of the algorithm are, there are, in order to use machine learning, we need to have pre-processing for the training data and testing data. For the pre-processing, so we have data set, tokenization, passive post-tagging. After that, we apply the algorithm and we test with the true requirement, the real requirement statement, and the classifier will give the classification result. Okay, first we have 40 requirement statements from 15 SRS, and we also do tokenization. This MRS given. The ANGRAM model is used for in order to segmentize, in order to get influences what before and after. The example of ANGRAM are unigram is 1 gram, 1 words. Bigram is 2 gram, 2 consecutive words. It's like overlapping. The catcher and the ND. So the catcher and the there is coming from the first one. So we need to have the overlapping of before and after. That's why we select the ANGRAM. And the last is root, trigram, quadrigram is 4 gram, 5 gram, 6 gram. According to my research, we found out that only 6 gram can capture the root that we have selected the based on our sentence. So we select 6 gram and we do passing and post-tagging because of we only focus on sentence structure and grammar. So the example of passing and post-tagging are given. According to example sentence, we have tested HED is DT for post-tagger, Kesha is noun for post-tagger, and EC. So based on that, we know that which word is lead to which grammar. So after that, we select 6 gram. After that, we label each word. We tag each word. After that, we do labeling. Labeling, like for example, we have 5 rules. So in according to the third sentence, we found the C2CC. So this is N and O. So we found this and all, there is a root one. If there is referential and root 2, root 3, root 3, root 5. And if there is no root 1 to 5 is applying, we just say others. So this is my, and after that we also eliminate words. We don't want to know the words, we just need the content of the grammar structure. So we eliminate words. And we also eliminate the duplication. Let's say if there are 2 rules applying in one sentence, for example, in the first sentence, the yellow one, PRP is personal pronoun. Personal pronouns and CC is connected position. We don't want 2 rules in one label. So we eliminate, so we replace PRP S in the second one, the blue highlighted one. We replace PRP S with the XX because we don't want 2 rules in the one sentence. This is our training sample of our training data set. This is pre-processing. So this is the training. After pre-processing finished, we got training data and we apply the algorithm. This is the naive-based classifier algorithm. The classification means in order to classify data into more than one group. So these are the algorithm classifying based on the highest counting number of the words is inside the training data. So this is my sample data interface. So user key in, then user click on check, it will display this one, okay? So what you will see originate test and eliminate test, we eliminate some, so based on their highest accuracy, let's say, subjective got 94.47. So the algorithm classifying based on the highest classifier, the higher probability. So the result is subjective, okay? And we also eliminate words which are commonly used in, robot engineer. And manual, we also validate with manual, like human expert. We have prepared like 30 requirement statement. We have selected 42 participants, and we found out that there are 3 results can be generated, which are ambiguous requirement, ambiguity rule, and time conception. Ambiguous requirement and ambiguity rule, if we say correct, if participant results are accurate and match with rule, we say is it correct. We calculate as a correct, accurate. If not, it's inaccurate. Time conserving, the participant has to set the time before and after attending the survey. So analysis result, we found out that naive classifier achieved higher accuracy in identifying ambiguous requirement with less time consuming. Then in conclusion, we found out that naive classifier achieved 27% higher than human in identifying ambiguous, and moreover, 63% accuracy in categorizing human in ambiguity rule, and 10% less time than average human time. Even though we found MBK's requirement with 40 minutes, live classifier identify one requirement statement with less than 1 minute, where human can identify one requirement statement using more than 1 minute. Therefore, we can conclude this research can benefit to recommend each practitioner using IPAD test specification algorithm. Our future work is, according to this example, we found that there are two rules applying, rule 1 and rule 2. We only can capture rule 1. Therefore, we found out we were select more rules, and we will try to using the same algorithm, and we were trying to classify more than one rule capturing in one sentence. I think that's all for today. That's all for today. If you have a question. Sorry that my presentation was fast.
So, being a tester, I find working to improve requirements
yes.
very nice and very important. You're working with just one rule at the moment, correct?
Yes, one rule in the sentence.
Right.
Yes.
So, you listed a bunch of other potential rules and things like that.
Yes.
Do you have any feel for how hard it's going to be to expand this classification to other rules and obviously make it more ready for the real world?
Actually, we selected the rule which has basis grammar. So from there we found out that these are very basic, these are also very important it's not only for the it's especially this our main goal is for requirement engineer who are constructing for software requirement specification. In order to do that, they should know at least correct grammar. So if they are written using, let's say, it and they in one sentence. So when user read this, like the stakeholder, when they read this one, they write why it and they are in the same sentence. What is it is referring to? What they is referring to? So they might confuse in the concept. Even though these are very simple grammar, it might confuse when you read the sentence. That's how it's we select this rule and we can perfect the
content. So. Have you looked or considered the implication of using things like more formal notation schemes? I'm thinking specifically of things like SysML and UML, which are designed to write requirements in
system. System is just based on training. We have that's why we did pre-processing. So in pre-processing, we already mentioned that. We don't want to know the words. We just want the contents of the grammar. So when the algorithm read the sentence, so because in our result, I have even shown, because the requirement sentences are with the words, right? With words, right? So we do post-tagging. Why it's not working today? Yeah. I want to show. Here. Okay, here. You see, according to this example, one user key in, like, is the user key in, like, just simple English, right? The system, cache, e, save. So, what we, let's say, you see the first, original test with post tagging. Original sentence is, we type the same sentence, like, we type post tagging because our training data is just post-tagging. If we don't do post-tagging, the algorithm cannot read anything. We need to do post-tagging for testing data. So the original sentence with post-tagging showed that THED is DT, system is now, cache is VBZ is verb, each is DT, determiner, SIL is now, M is CC, write VBZ, verb, them is PRP, personal pronoun. So it's like when algorithm solve this post tag, it will classify based on the highest counting number of post tags that we have in our training data. Let's say, according to this example, You see, the quantity congestion 0.02%, multiple verb 0.02%, pronoun 4.98, quantifier 0.5%, subjective 49.4%, 47. So according to this one, we found our subjective has the highest probability. Why? The Naive algorithm calculate based on the highest counting number of subjectives is here is adjective, JJ. According to this sentence, JJ. JJ has the highest counting number than other words here in this sentence. That's how it's classified. I'm waiting for Viva.
Oh, you're not there.
Yes.
Okay.
So
your research is only
got
one room?
No, we have five rooms.
Okay. That's why I'm going to ask you how many rooms that relevant to do your research.
Oh,
so you have five rooms?
Yes, I have five rooms.
But one thing is that your comparison, are you only compare with the main one?
Yes, humans, yes.
So you don't compare with other methods?
No. We only compare with humans.
Why
we
compare with other methods?
Yes. Other machine learning, yes, yes. We do that.
You want to show you are better, right? Nobody took it. I think you should consider that. To add. I mean, if you're waiting for one more, also at least you have to do yourself to compare.
All right,
with other methods.
Okay. That's all. Thank you.